Sports coverage of the National Football League brings us to historic Baltimore, Maryland and M&T Bank Stadium. Today it's week four and we've got what should be a great one here as it'll be the Los Angeles Rams taking on the Baltimore Ravens. Seems like we were just starting training camp, but here we are in October, and off we go on EA Sports. And he'll be stopped up at the 25. Start with an option going left. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That's a good way to start the drive. 17 yards and a touchdown. But he's certainly dangerous when he spots a lane, and he keeps it himself there and worked out well.
The moving parts on a play like this, you know you have to practice it over and over because it's almost like a ballet that has to be choreographed. But how about once he made the decision to go, he committed to it and went. Let's face it, most teams are going to defend the running back much more than the quarterback on that type of a play.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. And he will be brought down at about the 43 that time. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves them with third and 9 looming. This defense for the Rams, they were very strong last week in that win over Cleveland.
And one of the key things you always look for when you're evaluating a defense is how opportunistic are they? How many takeaways do they get per game? And how about last week's game?
And Jackson cannot get away, and he'll go down. Looks like a 9-yard loss, and it also brings up fourth. Only two punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. It's taken to the 26. A very good return that time. 18 yards. And the Rams will go on offense here with a first and 10.
You don't see that too often, Charles. He punted that away and then hustled up to make the stop as well.
Yeah, because oftentimes they serve as their own safety after punting it. You want to be the last guy, but he decided to get involved in the action, didn't he? And what a spark that's got to provide for the rest of his team when they see their punter out there making a nice hit.
And this intercepted on the first play of the game. And they'll set up shop in enemy territory at the 45-yard line.
So this is something we didn't see at all.
The victory last week, that's a turnover. They didn't have any, but giving the ball away here in the opening quarter.
I love the surprise in your voice because it's exactly what you stated. Didn't see it last week, but it's a key to their win. And it'll be a key to this game as well, protecting the football. Didn't get it done there.
What a nice burst there as he'll take this inside the 30 to the 28-yard line. The Ravens get a new set of downs, give them 17 on that pickup. He's got his man, it's Andrews. The Ravens at 1-2 through the first 3 weeks of the season, and they fell in the opener, got back on the beam with a win in week two, but stumbled again last week to fall under 500.
And despite that stumble, I don't think anyone's too concerned because they've made mistakes that they believe are correctable. And this is a team still getting to know each other. I'm not that concerned, and neither are they.
Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
On the carry, McGee. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Jackson. And it's intercepted at the goal line. And the Rams are going to have it here as they'll start at their own seven. The LA offense ready to go for their next drive. They got the ball now following a big play, keeping the other guys out of the end zone. Now they'll start deep in their own territory. And nothing but green grass here, middle of the field. Inside the 20. Touchdown, LA. A great effort there. With touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Rams are on the board first on the road here in Baltimore. Point after, right down the middle. Makes the score 7-0. Brown now to kick it away after the touchdown. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped it to 23-yard line. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. A big mistake last time they were on the field, tossing that interception inside the red zone and really taking away what had been a pretty successful drive up to that point.
Yeah, and I don't think there's any question about it. As they head out on the field for this drive, that whole offensive unit is just thinking redemption. You know, they moved it really well, didn't pay it off. This time, they want to make sure that ball ends up in the end zone, and they're the ones possessing it.
And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line.
Next teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just going to ask you, that wasn't the primary target. He's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again second and 10. Duvernay in motion. Again, they'll run. This is McGee. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. Here comes third and about a foot. This is McGee. He's not going to get there. That won't even be close. It was blown up in the backfield. Losing 2 yards that time, and now it's fourth down. The Ravens send their punter out now as he'll punt it away for the second time. Couldn't get it to check off. That kicks all the way into the end zone for a touchback. The Los Angeles offense set to begin their next drive.
Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown. Sometimes that's not really true, but last drive, that was the case. One play to get into the end zone, and now they'll try to duplicate that success.
He's got a man complete. Down the sideline he goes. Touchdown, LA. A big play there. An 80-yard touchdown. And the Rams are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point safely through. And that'll make the score 14-0. taken away after the touchdown. And he won't quite make it to the 25. Offense set at the line for this next drive. They find themselves in a good size hole here, and a good size hole early on in this game as they come up on first down. Excellent job pushing through tacklers that time to pick up six. If you start assessing what went wrong last week, Charles, in their loss, had nothing to do with the ground game. They ran it well.
And you also have to say to yourself as a team, don't go away from what worked. That's not the reason the game was lost. Running the football over time and you do it consistently usually translates into wins.
And they're hoping to do it consistently here.
That's good for a Baltimore first down.
They go play action with Jackson. And this is going to be hard by the tight end Andrews. A big change in field position there. That's 40 yards on the catch and run. Jackson. Oh, and his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. And the Rams are going to take over once again with a football at their own 20-yard line.
Wrong fucking button, bro. Wrong button.
Los Angeles offense set to begin their next drive.
That's fucking crazy, bro. Ain't no more one play touchdowns out this bitch. That's for damn sure. I just noticed why I can't see the marker on the field. Like where the ball going. George, what you done? We now a motherfucker can't even see the Come on, bro. Okay. Come on, bro. Who you playing on A with? Who you playing with? Oh. Jayana not playing? Oh. I ain't even gonna lie. That last pick was a fucking wrong button. So I ain't really impressed yet. You know, I ain't proved shit to us really yet. Come on, bro. Oh boy.
The LA offense ready to go for their next drive. Everything right now that they touch on this side of the football seems to turn the
ball. Stop the bullshit, bro. No fumble.
Able to get in there and run him down for what's going to be a
After the sack, oh, they're staring at a challenge basically from the other side of town. It's second and a country mile.
VL. VL. We got four completions for 238 yards. How the fuck they still in zone? Fuck out of here, yo. How the fuck is he still in zone with all those incompletions? Make it count. Still early. Can't throw no more picks though, LJ. Get off me. Hey, Bay, can you check the baked potato? Thank you. Can't believe Brad didn't got hurt off that pitch. Way to hold on to that shit, LJ. Get off me. What's up, pretty girl? Stop throwing stuff. What's that? Thank you. Set it down. Go be good. Stop being big. Ah, oh, there's some bullshit. Hey, George, can you hear me? Hey, yeah, you got to tell me whatever it is you doing with that shit, because if you doing it, I want to be able to do it too. Make it fair. We can't see the, we can't see where you passing on here. Usually you can see that shit. Good shit. Good shit.
splits the uprights, and a rout is on here in this first half.
Taylor Brown to kick off for the Rams.
Brown now to kick it away after the touchdown. To start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. And a drive that stalled out last time. Went for it on fourth, didn't get it. How does that translate here? I would imagine momentum's with the defense.
Definitely with the defense, because anytime anyone goes for it on fourth down, that's telling you as a defense that you can't stop us. We don't think that you can. And when you actually do, that may put a little dent in the confidence of the offense the next time they hit the field.
Yeah, we'll see if they can bring that pride the offense this go around. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. Now you've got to hustle your guys to the line and get them set. Jackson on first down. Slings it to Andrews, and it's complete. The tight end has it. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Off the play fake. Here's Jackson. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. Well, the incompletion, yes, but maybe here not the worst thing in the world.
No, now a first and 10 actually gives them a chance to regroup, relax just a little bit. They huddle up, talk it over. Then they get a chance to continue their drive.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. And the Rams are going to take over once again at their own 25-yard line. After the turnover, it's Tua. Open man right side is Cup complete. And he'll be out right at the 35. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down.
First down, Los Angeles.
From the gun, it's Tua. Got a man over the middle, and it's complete. The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Here's Tagovailoa to throw. That'll be caught. It's Cup. Now the Rams will signal for a timeout, their second, as they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Tua setting up shop to throw again. Being chased out left. Flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Let's see who this is on. Okay, so the penalty on the outside for illegal touching, and they'll have to come back and try it again. Tagovailoa to throw on second down here. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. Touchdown, Rams. A great effort there. As the first half is winding down, and the Rams would extend their lead here just before halftime. Point after, right down the middle, and that makes this 35-0 now. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And with only 9 seconds remaining, and not much time, we'll see how they play this. A pretty good-looking run there on first down. That'll go for 9 yards, just short of the line to gain. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. Here's McGee. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down. Two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number three. And how about this right out of the locker room? An onside kick attempt. The Rams going to get the football first here, and they look to build on their lead as the second half gets started. A very interesting call, and one that backfires. I know they're losing, Charles, but boy, to start the second half with the onside kick, risky.
Felt like a sense of urgency from their side, coupled with, you and I both know the special teams coordinators, they sell their key plays each and every week to the head coach, don't they? And I guarantee he's been selling this one.
And I think the ball's out, but this will fortunately wind up out of bounds. You can almost see inside his face mask there, the look of relief. He coughed it up, but it goes out of bounds. They keep it.
Someone carrying around the lucky horseshoe, aren't they? If I were him, I'd go out and play the lottery after that one. A very fortunate man.
And they're operating in plus territory here. They're thinking points. Definitely don't want to lose the football at this juncture. Here's Tua. He's got his tight end on the corner route. It's complete. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down. And from the gun, here's Abanikanda. And this play gets blown up. They'll lose yardage back at the 17. Now that's going to go as a loss of 6, and it'll set them back for second down. Going to the air, Tagovailoa. And this is caught. He's got it. Touchdown, LA. From 17 yards out. And the Rams have taken a 6 touchdown lead. Extra point right down the middle, and it is 42-0. Brown now to kick it away after the touchdown. And out a little across the 25 to the 27. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going.
Well, we're still in the third quarter, so there's some time to kind of clean this up and make it look more respectable now. Or win, that's probably gone out the window, Charles. But I don't know, do you look at this as a time to just improve and maybe start to look towards the future?
I think you have to find something to play for, something to grasp onto, and so the clock runs out. But Brandon, we've been around this game a long time. This is an outlier. You don't get many blowouts like this, no matter how the game looks on paper going in. This one has turned out to be everyone's worst nightmare realized.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. They get 14 on that one. That's good for a Baltimore first down. They'll run with McGee. He gets away from one. And he'll get this up past the 45 to the 47. The 71 yards for him on the ground now, as he has been terrific here this afternoon. Here now, second and 4. They'll keep it on the ground. McGee, and he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Broke through some contact, but unable to reach the 40. A solid run on first down, gain of 7, leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
And when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
On second down now, McGee, and tackled down after a gain of 3, leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down.
That's a gain of 3. It's 3rd and 1.
This is incomplete. Oh, he had 6 points right in his hands, but could not hang on. We're in Baltimore. Third quarter action, 2nd and 10. Harris running straight ahead. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of 2. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
Now with just 1 second showing on the play clock, we're going to get a timeout. It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Here now a 3rd down and 8. They'll bring a receiver in motion right. Throw caught by Flowers. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. So another 3rd down conversion, and now they've got a 1st and goal. Here's Jackson to throw. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up
incomplete. Wow. God damn, bro. What it is, bro?
Justin Tucker to kick off for Baltimore.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Cost him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. The L.A. offense ready to go for their next drive. Still well in control of this ball game, despite giving up that touchdown a moment ago. He'll be dropped at the 25 after a gain of 6.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of 1st downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
Meanwhile, Tua's, and this throw brought in here by Mayer. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. On the handoff, Abana Campbell. And he works free. And he finally goes down, but not before reaching the 20. They come to the line, they will not be able to get back now in Baltimore. And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the 4th quarter. A very one-sided affair. Here's Tagovailoa on 1st and 10. Got a man and he hits him in stride. Not quite the success they had last play. This one goes for 3 yards.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
Let's go. On 2nd down, it's Abana Kanda. And he's going to take this one in for a Rams touchdown. Israel Abana Kanda with his 2nd touchdown of the afternoon. And the Rams continue to pour it on here in the 4th. Extra point splits the uprights. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to that big lead. Brown now to kick it away after the touchdown. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive.
We said it at halftime that they would need a nearly perfect second half to erase that deficit that they were facing, CD. But unfortunately, the second half has pretty much been a carbon copy of the first.
Yeah, that early lead was almost insurmountable the way their opponent was playing. And Parker, they do have some good news, though. This one is getting close to being over, and they can try and hit the reset button starting tomorrow.
They wind up losing 10 on the sack, and it'll lead to a third and long.
But one thing I do know, these guys on defense, they don't want this game to end. They're winning by multiple touchdowns. They've shut down the opposing quarterback in a big way, and they're still picking up sacks as we approach the end of this one.
And now here is another interception. How about this? And this return is going to be halted right around the 28-yard line.
That'll take over first and 10 at the 28-yard line.
Now Tua signaling to change things up. The give now to Abanikanda, and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge. And a lot of times, these plays, they either go for nothing or they go for big yardage. And here, they got to the outside, turned it upfield, and ended up getting a nice little gain out of it.
And oh, it'll be intercepted. And the Ravens are going to have the football at their own 1 yard line. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. So now, Charles, this drive, maybe a touch more important, trying to erase the memory of that interception they had the last time out.
And everyone goes through this because even the best in the game, you're going to have games where it just doesn't go right for you and interceptions result. So, frankly, to me, it's all about how you respond, not just the types of plays that you call, but how you carry yourself, how you show your team that you're still with it, and how you continue to lead.
The Ravens going to use the second of their timeouts. That's going to leave them with just one remaining here in this fourth quarter.
It's all about teamwork.
This offense so far on third down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. This will be 3rd and 6. To throw is Jackson. And my goodness, another interception. And they're already in the red zone. The 18-yard line is where they take over. So from inside the 20, here's 1st and 10 at the 18. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And he's got his big tight end here. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. 2nd and right at a yard. Line of scrimmage, the 9. 2nd and about a yard. They fake the handoff. Now Tua. This will be caught at about the 6. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. Point after, right down the middle. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to that big lead. Brown now to kick it away after the touchdown. And they're going to have good starting field position. He's out of bounds, but not before he's across the 35. Baltimore with good starting field position as they come up 1st and 10 at their own 37. Now Jackson. And now here is another interception. And the Rams are going to have it here at their own 32-yard line. Another great play defensively. They've been sharp on both sides of the ball, Charles, but that interception means that this defense very well keep them down to single digits on the scoreboard in this game.
And that's certainly something to smile about, isn't it, partner, if you're on defense? Because your goal every
is something to take pride in.
Off of play action, Tagovailoa. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Multiple players getting home there for an 8-yard loss. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. The D can only stop it one more time as they take the knee. Ravens going to use their third and final timeout. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. Throwing now is Tagovailoa. Going up top. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
Well, I think it's pretty evident that any blowout isn't going to be big enough for them. They're already up 7 full touchdowns, and it's still not stopping them from throwing it deep downfield, taking their shots, trying to add more points.
And that'll hit at the 5 and go into the end zone for a touchback. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Well, CD, it's all window dressing at this point. I mean, the best they can do is end the game with a nice drive to maybe build some momentum to move forward into their next contest.
Yeah, with how lopsided this game has been, even one score might not do a lot of cosmetic good on the scoreboard, partner, because it's just about looking forward at this point. Get a touchdown here, give yourself some positive momentum and reps.
And my goodness, another interception. And the Rams will have solid field position here as they take over at the 35-yard line. The L.A. offense ready to go for their next drive. They're looking at a third straight win here if they can hold on. They'll begin on the ground here to the Bandicanda. And across midfield he goes into Raven territory. 94 yards rushing for him now in the ball game. This second and 4. That one looks like he'll throw here. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
Well, their passing attack, even though that one was incomplete, has been really sharp in this one. It's resulted in a lot of touchdowns, and it looks like they're not going to stop throwing the football until the very end of this one.
Well, that will certainly make everyone involved on offense pretty happy, because that gives them all a chance to pad their stats a bit. But as far as the actual need, you and I both know they can just run this clock out, because this one, it was over a long time ago.
Well, let's face it, not a lot left for them to prove in this game, but they're still throwing the football. I guess, of course, CD, you know, you could always get the backup some work. There's new plays to try out. But some people, let's face it, they just want to run the score up. It's fun.
I love the way that you expressed that, because you gave plenty of reasons why people like to do things. But ultimately, they just like to keep their foot on the gas, and they just want to tromp on teams. And what I like to see is, if you like to do that, how do you handle it when it comes back against you? On those days where someone can run it up on you, do you handle it the way that you expect your opponent to? If so, keep doing your thing.
So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Now Jackson back into his end zone. Looking for his running back, and he's got it. And he's able to get this up just shy of the 15. That'll go for a gain of 13, helping big time to get away from that end zone. First down. One last shot for Jackson. And that is going to officially draw the curtain on this one as the last throw intercepted. Well, fans usually love to see scoring, and there was no shortage of it today. What a dominant showing from an offense that was truly playing at